Harper Audio presents Wedgie and Gizmo versus the Toof by Suzanne Selfors. Performed by Johnny Heller and Maxwell Glick.
Chapter 1. Gizmo. Greetings, dear reader. Most of you already know who I am, but in case you are new to this planet or you've spent the last few frozen in a block of ice and are not up to date on important matters, I shall introduce myself. My name is Gizmo, and I am an evil genius. According to Eliot's comic book collection, which I enjoy reading, all evil geniuses have the same goal as I have: to take over the world. Thus far, no evil genius has been successful in taking over the entire world, but I will change that. It is my promise to you that I will be the very first evil genius who will rule from sea to sea, mountain to mountain, pet store to pet store. Prepare yourself for the day when King Gizmo is seated on his evil throne. I should note that I am different from other evil geniuses because I am a cavie. For reasons I do not understand, humans tend to call my kind guinea pigs. How insulting. Pigs are lowly creatures who muck about in the mud. Cavies are noble creatures who nap in the sun. Pigs eat slop out of buckets. Cavies eat organically grown greens from a plate. Pigs snort. Cavies purr. Speaking of cavies, in order to take over the world, I will need a horde of them to follow me and do my evil bidding. And so that brings me to today's evil goal. Recruit my cavie horde. I tried to contact other cavies through my evil genius Facebook page, but I have not yet received any messages. I fear that most of my kind live in cages and do not have access to the internet. So I realize that I need a more primitive way to reach them. Thus I designed a flyer. I want you for my cavie horde. Are you tired of living in a cage? Would you like to meet other cavies? Waddle through foreign lands, eat whatever you like. Then join my horde today and help me take over the world. Signed, Gizmo, the evil genius. But how can I deliver this flyer and make sure it gets into the paws of cavies everywhere? I scratch my furry chin and ponder. Dad.
Hi, Elliot. Hi, Jasmine. How was school?
Elliot. It was okay. Jasmine. Elliot got a trophy for shooting the most baskets in a contest.
Dad. Really?
Elliot. It's no big deal. I've got lots of trophies. Jasmine. I've never gotten a trophy. Not for anything. Why must those humans always speak so loudly and disturb my important evil thoughts? What a nuisance they are. The only one of whom I'm fond is Elliot. He is my servant. He provides me with fresh snacks, changes my litter, and delivers sticks for chewing. We cavies like to chew. It keeps our teeth sharp and perfectly proportioned. An evil genius must always look his best.
Mom. Elliot, Jasmine, come get a snack.
Elliot. Great, 'cause I'm starving.
Elliot picks me up. I grunt with annoyance. Where are we going? I am very busy using my evil brain. But then I squeak with glee as we enter one of my favorite rooms in this new house. It is the place where the humans store their edibles. I sniff the air. So many delightful scents fill my quivering nostrils. My tummy rumbles as Elliot sets me onto the counter. Will he give me an apple slice or a strawberry top? Or perhaps he will give me the treasure of all human foods, a marshmallow. These humans never feed me marshmallows. I have heard them say they are bad for me and will make me sick. Such nonsense. They simply do not wish to share. But wait, what is that commotion? The girl child has entered the kitchen. I grunt at her, but she does not heed my warning. She scoops me up, squeezes me, then plants kisses on my forehead. I understand why she wants to kiss me. I am quite handsome, with soft, velvety fur. And I am perfectly plump all over. She cannot resist me. Who could? But being squeezed is most unpleasant. I bite her finger. She releases me. It is a trick I have taught her. Now, if only I can teach her to give me a marshmallow. What's this?
My ears perk. My heart skips a beat. Alas, I hear the familiar sound of nails clicking against the floor. I peer over the edge of the counter and glare at what I see. It is the canine who lives in this house. The dog. He looks up at me. He wags his tail, even though it's not a long tail, just a stub. He smiles sweetly, but he is not fooling me. The humans call him Wedgie, but I know him by his true name. He is a corgi, and when he wears the red cape of Thor, he becomes Thorgi, my archenemy.
Chapter 2. Wedgie. My name's Wedgie, and I'm a very happy dog because it's snack time. I love snack time. I stand in the kitchen next to Jasmine and Elliot and Jackson. They're my pack. I love my pack. My most important job is to protect my pack. That's why I always wear my cape. When I wear my cape, I'm super Wedgie, and I protect my pack with my superpowers. Like the power of digging, and the power of chasing, and the power of herding. But right now, I want a snack. I'm wagging my stubby tail. Snacks make me so happy. I like all food. I like dog food, and cat food, and fish food. But people food is the very best. I smell cookies. I wag extra hard. Hey, I'm down here. Can I have a snack? Something is squeaking. I look up. Furry potatoes on the counter. Hello, furry potato. I love the furry potato. I like to smell him all over, but I can't reach him. I jump and jump and jump, but he's way up there, and I'm way down here. Jasmine. Mom, they handed this out at school today. Cloverland Elementary's Parade of Pets. 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Tuesday, September 23rd, in the gymnasium. All pets must be in carriers or on leashes. All dogs must be friendly. Trophies awarded for best trick, prettiest pet, and best owner pet look-alike. Jasmine. Can I take Wedgie again this year? Mom. Last year he got into a lot of trouble, remember? He chased that cat and he ate the principal's speech. Jackson. And he pee-peed on the floor. Mom. The principal was very upset. Jasmine. I know, but he'll be better this year. I won't let him off the leash. I promise. Mom. Okay, as long as he behaves himself. Jasmine. Yay! Did you hear that, Wedgie? We're going to be in the pet parade. Jasmine's talking to me. She pats my head. She scratches my rump. I lick her face. But she doesn't give me a cookie. Elliot's eating a cookie. Jackson's eating a cookie. Even Dad's eating a cookie. How come no one gives me a cookie? I decide to use my superpower of staring. I sit next to Jackson and stare at him, real hard. I sit very still and stare and stare and stare and stare and stare and stare and stare. I want that cookie. Please, oh, please, oh, please give me that cookie. My superpower works. Jackson drops the cookie. I open my mouth and catch it before it hits the floor. I eat it super fast so no one can take it from me. That was a really good cookie. I want another one. Please, oh, please, oh, please, can I have another cookie? Jasmine. The whole school thinks Wedgie's a bad dog just because he made a mess last year at the parade. If we win, then everyone will know he's the best dog ever. And I'll get a trophy. I mean, we will get a trophy. Elliot, why do you care so much about a trophy? They're no big deal. They give them out for everything these days. What's that sound? I bark at the sound. I follow the sound onto the porch. A truck is stopping across the street. Some people get out. I bark at the people. Hey, I'm Super Wedgie, and I just ate a really good cookie. The people wave. A girl waves. She's holding something. What's that smell? It's a new smell. It's a bit mushroomy and a bit squirrely. But I've never smelled it before. I want to know what it is because I love this new smell. I run down the walkway. I squeeze under the gate and run across the road. Jasmine, Wedgie, bad dog, come back. I need to find this new smell. I sniff my way right up to the girl. She sets something on the ground. I stop wagging. I stop panting. I stare real hard. The new smell stares back at me. I don't know what I'm looking at, but I'm pretty sure I love it.
Chapter 3. Gizmo. After serving me an apple slice, Elliot carries me back to my eco-habitat. My evil brain buzzes with ideas. In one of Elliot's comic books, Darth Vader, an evil villain, forms an army of stormtroopers to do his evil bidding. I, too, will have my own army, only they will be smaller and furrier, but equally fierce. I must begin my plans to form my cavey horde. First, however, I shall take a post-snack nap. But why is Thorgy barking outside? Such rudeness. My naps are of the utmost importance. If I do not get enough sleep, I become rather cranky. And when I get cranky, I bite. I waddle across the bookcase and hop onto the windowsill. The window is open, so I squeeze beneath the crack.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.